students, now I am going to take science for you. Okay students, so if you have science textbook, please take a science textbook and open page number 57. Open children, so I think all of you opened our textbook, page number 57. So this is a new lesson. So the lesson name is soil. So soil, for what purpose we will use children? So for growing crops. No children, so we use soil for growing crops. Now let us study about soil. Okay children, now read the lesson, listen carefully. Can this flower smile like this if there is no soil? Is soil so important to grow crops? Think and discuss. So if soil now is not there, the flowers will be shed. They won't give the smile. So for growing plants, flowers, all we need soil. So it is very important. Soil is very important. Next, what is soil? Means soil andre eno? Remember playing in the dirt with your friends. You probably didn't put too much thought into how the dirt was formed or even what it was made of. Dirt is dirt, right? Well, actually that dirt is called soil. And the mannu marulu kalitu agiruttalva, so that is called soil. And soil is a mixture of mineral and organic material that sits just below earth's surface. So what soil contains means it is a mixture of minerals and organic materials. So it will be under the earth surface. Next, the upper layer of the earth surface is called soil. It is important for the growth of plants. We grow vegetables, fruits and other plants in the soil. The plants take up water and mineral from the soil through the roots. So earth is there, no? So earth means bhoomi. Bhoomi mele iruttalva adanna navu soil anta karitivi. So why it is important means, so it is important to grow the plants. So we will grow plants, we will grow vegetables, fruits and also other plants in the soil. Now soil inda navu enen belithivi andre plants matte vegetables fruits matte bere bere tara plants alla belithivi. So these plants take water from where it will take means mineral. So it will take up water and minerals from the soil through the roots. Roots andre bere bere in the soil from the soil in the roots bere olgadinda neer tagolutte. So what does soil contain? Soil olgade enen irutte? Soil is made up of rock particles, clay, remains of plants and animals called humus and stones. So what it will be means, rock means small kallugalu, chikku chikku kallu, clay andre mannu marulu, jedi mannu athralla yeltella mannu kulu adalla irutte. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್ಸ್ದು ಸತ್ತೋಗಿರುತ್ತಲ್ವ, ಆನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ದು ನೋಣ ಈ ಥರ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸತ್ತೋಗಿರುತ್ತಲ್ವ, ಅದರೆಲ್ಲ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಫೈನ್ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅಂದರೆ ಕಲ್ಲುಗಳು, ದಪ್ಪ ದಪ್ಪ ಕಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಒಳಗಡೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ 1, ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ದ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್. ಸಿ ಆರ್ ದ ಗಿವನ್ ಎ experiment that what soil contains. First point, go into a field, collect a sample of soil. Second point, put it in a jar of water, stir it well and let it settle. Third point, observe and discuss the different layers of materials. So first you go to the field and take some soil, and next is you bring the soil and put into the jar of water. So first you put water inside the jar and then put that soil inside the jar. After you mix it well and let the soil settle down, and after you observe what are the different layers of the material. See here, they given here down one gravel, 10 to 2. Next is thick sand, 2 to 0.2. Next is fine sand, so 0.2 to 0.06. Next is silt, so that is 0.06 0.002. Next is clay, 0.002. Next is water, and up it will be organic deteriorates. Okay children, next. Soil contains water in the form of moisture because different particles of soil have different water holding capacity. So in water, particles will settle more quickly the bigger they are. It is possible to use this property to determine the amount of each component of the soil. So put 3 pots of water and 1 pot of soil in the container and shake the container for 5 minutes and let the material sit, that you have put it soil now, let it sit down. Next, after 40 seconds you measure the thickness of the sediment, so that is called A, and after again 30 minutes measure again and call, that is called B, and after 24 hours, after 1 day, you measure C. Now by subtraction you can determine the thickness of the main layer. C minus B equals layer of clay, B minus A layer of silt, A equals layer of gravel and sand. Using the sieve with 2 mm holes, you can separate the gravel from the sand and determine their ratio. On the basis of this data, calculate the content, 0% percentage of each component of the soil sample. This one you can do in your home. So second activity, to show that soil contains water. So soil also contains water, that we can do with this experiment. So what are the materials required to do this experiment is, first is soil, next spirit lamp, next third one a metal can with a lid. So what are the methods how to do that one, they given here. Take a little quantity of soil in a metal can, cover it with a lid, ask an adult to heat the can, take off the lid. Observation, you will find drops of water on the lid. Result, this shows that soil contains water. So first, what you must do, first you must take some soil and put it inside the metal can. After, you must close the metal can with a lid. After, you must ask for your elders to eat that can with a spirit lamp. So after eating that one, you must open that lid. So what you will see there, so you will see so drops of water on the lid. So by this experiment we can know that the soil also contains water. So here they given some fact finder, soil contains 45% minerals, 25% water, 25% air and 5% organic matter. Next, different types of plants grow in the soil and number of small animals also live in the soil. It proves that soil contains air. So how we can prove that soil contains air means, so different types of plants will grow in the soil and number of so many animals will be there inside the soil, and small animals also will be there inside the soil. So by this we can know that soil also contains air. Next is third activity, third experiment, to show that soil contains water. So what are the materials required? Soil jar of filled with water. So what we want means soil and jar. That jar must be half filled with water. So what are the methods? Take some soil from the ground and keep it in a jar half filled with water. What happens? So you go to the field, take some soil from there and you take a jar. In that jar you pour half of the water and afterwards you put that soil inside. So what you will see means, you see the bubbles of air arising up from the surface of the soil. So when you are pouring the water, so some bubbles andre gulle, so that will be rising up from the soil. So this shows that trapped air in the soil rising up the up of the soil. So air will be inside now, that will rise up from the soil. Okay children, next, how soil forms. Crops get eaten during the day and cool down at night. This eating and cooling break down rocks into the smaller pieces. When water flows over these rocks pieces, it turns them into pebbles, which are carried to far off places by water. Slowly, these tiny pieces become very small. These small pieces were also rubbed against each other till they become very tiny pieces. So how soil forms means, so morning during the day the rocks will get heat, so it will be very hot, and in the night time it will be very cool. So this eating and cooling, it will break down the rocks into small pieces. So when the water flows on these rocks, the pieces, then it will turn into the pebbles, means small stones, and it will be carried to the far off places by the water. And slowly these tiny pieces, it will become very small, and these small pieces will also rub against, it will be rubbed against two, when there are two stones it will be rubbing, and while being rubbed it will become still smaller pieces. So the soil so formed is called silt or sand, depending upon the kind of the rock. So this is called a formation of soil, and we'll call it as silt or sand. Next, soil profile. Soil is formed in number of layers. This sequence is called the soil profile. If we dig deep into the ground, we will find that each layer of the soil is different. So in the soil also there are number of layers. So if we dig deep into the ground, we will find so many layers, it will be different. The top layer of the soil is dark colored, it is called topsoil. Below it lies a light colored layer full of broken rock pieces, so this is called subsoil. The bottom layer is made up of solid rock called the bedrock. So top layer will be there, no? So it will be dark color. So that one we will call it as a topsoil. And next down, it lies very light, it will be light color. So the rocks will be broken into pieces. So that is called subsoil. And next bottom, it must be solid rock. It is made up of solid rock, and that is called a bedrock. So in this picture they have shown which is topsoil, which is subsoil, and which is bedrock. See, top of the, it is called topsoil, a horizon. Subsoil is in the middle, on the root it will be there, so that is called b horizon. And next is parent, c horizon, and last it is bedrock. So how many types of soil are there? There are three types of soils. So topsoil, subsoil, and bedrock. Next is kinds of soil. So there are so many different kinds of soil. So how many soil, different kinds of soils are there? Means four different kinds of soils are there. So what are they, children? So they are sand, clay, silt, loam. So first we can study about sand. Sand is a number main particle found in soil. You can tell it is sandy soil by how rough it feels as you rub it between your fingers. This soil is a combination of rock, quartz, or silica. Sandy soil is what's needed in areas requiring drainage, like baseball field, but doesn't contain enough nutrients to grow strong, healthy plants. When melted down, sandy soil becomes glass. Thus, this sand is mainly found in the soil. So, we can't tell whether it is a sandy soil and how rough it is. And if you rub between your fingers, it feels rough. So, the soil is a combination of rock, quartz or silica. So it will be like a baseball, and in the drainage it will be there or field, but it doesn't contain so many nutrients to grow strong and healthy. So it is melted down and sandstone and become a glass. So next is clay. Another type of soil is clay. When it is dry, clay feels smooth to the touch. So this clay, when it will dry, when you touch it, it will be very smooth, but it becomes very sticky when wet. So when it is wet, we will feel it as sticky ange antkondi irutte. So it is made of small inorganic particles have been worn down from rock. Clay can be full of healthy nutrients. So this clay soil, so it will be very healthy, nutrients will be there, but doesn't allow enough water and air to pass through the support most plants. But it won't allow more water and give support to plant. Because it is so sticky and dry sort, clay is very good for building and making pottery. So clay soil, what it is good? So what all, where do we use this clay soil? Means for building and making pottery, we will use this clay soil. So next is silt. Silt is a combination of sandy soil and clay. You can tell silt by how powdery it feels when it is dry. Unlike clay, silt does not become sticky when it is wet. Next is loam. Loam is a combination of sandy soil, clay and silt. It breaks up easily, allows for organic activity and stays moist while allowing for drainage and air circulation. Loam is the best soil for growing plants. In fact, gardeners often mix loam with other soils like sand and clay. So this loam, so sandy soil, clay and silt, it is all mixed and we can call it as loam, and it breaks up easily and it will allow organic activity and it is allowed for drainage and air circulation, and it is best for growing plants. So gardeners, what they'll do, they will mix this loam with other soil like sandy and clay to grow plants. Next is soil and crops. We grow different crops in different types of soil. Some crops need loam, some need sandy soil, and some need clay soil. To grow better crops, the soil should contain air, water and minerals. We supply minerals and humus to the soil by adding minerals and fertilizers. So there are different crops to grow different types of soil. So some crops will need loam soil, some crops will need clay soil, and some crops will need sandy soil. So to grow the crops, it is better it should contain air, water and minerals and sunlight also. So we supply all this one by adding manures and fertilizers. So soil is formed by a breaking up of rocks. Soil particles differ in size and color. Soil contains stones, sand, clay and humus. So children, any doubt children? So this is called, these are all the about soil, and we have four kinds of soil, that is sand, clay, silt, loam. So soil is very useful. It provides water to minerals to the plants, and soil have so many layers. Any doubt children? I think you could have understood this lesson. So shall I ask some question children? So what are the main kinds of soil children? So there are four kinds of soil. So they are sand, clay, silt, loam. So how is loam useful children? So loam is the best soil for growing plants. Okay children, next. What is humus children? Can anyone say children? So dead and decaying remain of plants and animals are called humus. Okay children, any doubt children? So I think you could have understood this lesson. So I am giving the notes also. So please write the notes in the classwork neatly. Okay, children. Thank you.